Hi, Alex here. Today I'm bringing you another great sustainability tool. I hope you find it as useful as I do. It's a four-step approach to create effective and rigorous sustainability plans, and it's as simple as ABCD. So in previous videos, we discussed that using backcasting from principles of success can help us adopt a different way of thinking to achieve sustainability, and also that achieving checkmate and winning the sustainability game can be described as complying with four scientific sustainability principles that have been peer-reviewed and continuously refined over the last 20 years. So if we combine backcasting from sustainability principles with some common strategic planning methods that you may already know of, we get a simple step-by-step approach to strategic sustainability planning in four steps. A. Awareness. First, we need to make sure that we have a common language in our team, our department, or our organization, and that we all agree on what it means to play the game of sustainability and what the rules of the game are. It sounds obvious, but often people use different definitions. B. Baseline. Assessing current reality. This is where we are today. It's about completing a diagnosis of our current situation. It usually includes a sustainability impact analysis to identify key infractions to the four sustainability principles and key sustainability challenges. It can also include an assets inventory and an evaluation of stakeholder relationships. C. Compelling vision. This is about creating a sustainability vision and imagining potential solutions to the challenges identified in the baseline assessment. The vision includes complying with the four sustainability principles, but also our core purpose and our core values. Using backcasting is very powerful here. It prevents us from proposing only solutions to problems that we have today. With the end in mind, we can suggest solutions that will help us create the sustainable future that we want for ourselves. D. Decide on priorities. This step is about choosing between the solutions proposed in the previous step and deciding which ones are most strategic while allowing for tactical flexibility. Three questions can help us decide strategically on priorities here, and this will be the topic of another video. So this is a very flexible approach. You can apply it to a product, a department, the whole company, or the whole community. And it's also cyclical, and you always revisit and refine A, B, C, D. So applying this ABCD planning methodology many times with businesses and communities, I have found that the most important element is the gap between our current situation and our vision, because that's what creates the creative tension. A lot of the time, when we know where we are and where we want to be, we just go there. Creating this tension upstream generates action and motion downstream. That's why it's important to be rigorous and honest while assessing our current situation and to be ambitious while creating our vision. Pretending that the current situation is better than it really is and/or creating a vision that is not very ambitious can feel more comfortable, but it reduces the creative tension and therefore reduces our chances to generate action and motion in the right direction. Is that useful? Tell me what you think in the comments down below. I will bring you more videos to show how this ABCD methodology has been applied successfully to concrete projects with businesses and communities, so stay tuned. Subscribe to receive the new videos and follow us on Facebook and Twitter for the latest news. If sustainability education is important to you, please consider becoming a patron. By making a pledge of $1 or more for each new video, you can help us create more engaging videos so everyone can learn about sustainability. Check out patreon.com/sustainability. Thank you to our patrons. We can't make these videos without you, and thank you for watching.